salga de la cama. Enseguida me ordenó, yo le obedecí y verán lo que pasó.
¿Qué es lo que pasó?
Que se desmayó.
Hello ladies, sorry for being late. Today's cumbia, I forgot what number of lesson is today, but let's start working. Alright, if I'm not wrong, we've been working some of the basics for cumbia. So, I guess we can do is like, kinda take you ladies to the next level. So, let me see. Let me see what we can do tonight. Now, I don't know if you guys can hear this, the song I just played. It's kinda like old school. So, you can hear it's a little bit different than probably what stuff that you guys hear before, like this.
Quiero relatar lo que a mí me sucedió jugando la otra noche, mi sueño se turbó. Hubo donde pararlo, con algo me apuntó. Encendí la luz cuando vi que era un ladrón. Cuando me miró, yo temblando lo miré. Jugando se acercó y yo sin nada me quedé. Salga de la cama, enseguida me ordenó. Yo le obedecí y verán lo que pasó.
¿Qué es lo que pasó?
Se desmayó. Ven, 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 ladronzuelo, ven. Pero ven y ven y ven a robarme a mí. Pero ven, 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 ven. Se desmayó. Ven, 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 ladronzuelo, ven. Pero ven y ven y ven a robarme a mí. Pero ven, 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 ladronzuelo, ven. Pero ven y ven y ven a robarme a mí.
Y now you see the music's not so complicated. It's kind of like old school. Is like still today, you know, I love music. It doesn't matter if it's old school or new school. It is fun to dance. That's why I love what I do for a living, right? I just dance all the time. I love to teach, right? And so I really have a good time all the time I teach how to dance, right? So cumbia at the beginning is not hard. If you guys remember some of the steps I teach the class before, I was doing this like 1, 2, 3. Just don't forget, Latinos, we like to tap, right? So no se olviden que a los latinos nos gusta hacer o la patadita o el tap con el tacón, right? Y después con el mismo que pie que utilizan para eso, pisan hacia atrás, right? Y se van así, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So most of the time, you always start in the count number 8. So siempre empezamos en el paso número 8, right? So, si quieren bailar, digamos, old school, right? O como la vieja escuela, siempre empiecen con este paso, right? Siempre se empiecen hacia atrás, right? O hay algunos que se quedan en el mismo lugar, right? Pueden hacer un poquito de taps, right? Un poquito de shimmy, right? Con brazos, right? Hay un paso común que todos los latinos hacemos. So it's a common step that we all Latinos we do. Kind of going to the side, right? You can keep it small and easy, or you can go big, right? So that's kind of all based in your style, right? So todo es basado a tu estilo, como lo quieras hacer, right? Ahora, eso es kind of la vieja escuela. Hoy en día se baila un poquito diferente. Todavía hay padres o madres o familiares que le enseñan a los pequeños bailar como se bailaba antes, ¿verdad? So he visto muchos chicos de hoy en día que todavía bailan como la vieja escuela porque los papás les enseñan a bailar así. O aprenden viendo a las gentes mayores en sus casas. Right? So is old school dance, the way they dance cumbia still is being done today, especially for young people. That I think it is because either parents teach to the kids, or the kids see the parents. This is how I learned. Like I didn't have a teacher, a dance teacher, right? But I used to go to the parties, so the parties used to happen in my house or in the street of my house. I used to see my parents. I used to like learn by imitating my parents, right? Or my uncles, right? So that's how I learned how to dance, right? But I think today is happening the same thing, or always happen the same thing, right? Always the young generation always learn from the old generation by watching them how to dance, and they just trying the steps, right? Pero al mismo tiempo, muchas de las veces la nueva generación tiende a crear su propio estilo, y yo creo que eso pasa muchas veces porque el estilo de la música cambia, right? Si el estilo de la música cambia, el baile cambia, ¿verdad? Y especialmente todos cambiamos, todas las generaciones son muy diferentes. Normalmente la generación nueva se revela a la generación vieja y quiere hacer algo diferente, no quiere hacer lo que los viejos hacen, como quien dice, ¿verdad? So you have to understand that as the time pass, the music changes, and if the music changes, the dance change, right? And most of the time, the young generation, they don't want to do what the old generation been done, right? And they want to do something different. So now, you guys hear that song that I just played, that's kind of the old school. Now, listen this is kind of the new school. Go, I think, yes. So and now you can see, both ways or comparable ways are like opposites, right? So kind of definitely the style that's done today, some people call it like cumbia huepa, right? It's a lot of work. I'm not gonna lie, I like it, right? But it's a challenge. Like dance all the time like this for someone like me, I'm getting old, so. It's kind of hard to keep up with that kind of stuff because it's a lot of work, right? But anyway, you guys see, you know, that's not just the only way, right? So let me introduce you today something we call guaracha, right? So guaracha is a style born in Cuba, moved to Mexicans. We've been adapting or kind of like. Grab some of the styles that around the world it happens, right? You didn't kind of change it, what happened in our country. I don't think the huaracha has been done in Cuba is similar to the huaracha has been done in Mexico, especially in Mexico City. This is where the style is the strongest for this style. So let me do a few basics so you guys can see what I'm talking about. If you guys want to, you can try it. Yeah. So when I go straight with the basic. Now, the basic huaracha is the same of cumbia. Right? So we do this before. It's this one here, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Right? But huaracha, it can be a solo or a partner war dance, right? So you can dance with a partner or by yourself. So these are a small step that you guys can do. They tend to do a lot of kicks, right? Yeah, a lot of taps, right? So let's say for example, if I do my basic step. what we do is, sorry, my kid loves to teach. He's 3 years old, he died to be here. So every time he got a chance, he just do it. Alright, so thanks to my wife, he's containing the monster. Alright, 3 years old. Alright, so I want you to start getting used to when you dance guaracha. Alright, you're gonna tap. So let's say you are in your basic step, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright? But now I want you to be aware about this, alright? So I dance a salsa style where our stronger steps always happen with the left leg, right? So yo bailo un estilo de salsa donde siempre mi pie izquierdo es el principal que utilizo. Y eso es completo. Sorry, I've been sick for a while now, so it's no coronavirus, so don't worry about it. It's just a cough. So sorry. Just I want you to be aware, especially for los latinos, right? Quiero que entiendan que en el estilo de salsa que yo bailo, mi estilo fuerte siempre es el pie izquierdo, right? Y es completamente lo opuesto al estilo como se baila la guaracha. En la guaracha, el chico, el paso fuerte siempre es con el pie derecho. Eso es lo opuesto de lo que yo hago. ¿Verdad? Y la chica siempre utiliza el pie izquierdo como lo estoy utilizando hoy. So, quiero que los chicos entiendan que estoy haciendo, digamos, los pasos de la chica en este momento. ¿Verdad? Para que si ustedes son chicos y quieren aprender guaracha, hagan lo opuesto que voy a hacer. ¿Verdad? Como mirarse en un espejo. Si ven que muevo la pierna izquierda primero, los chicos mueven la pie derecha primero. Alright? So for the ladies, they're taking lessons often from me. Alright? So normally in guaracha, in Mexico, guys always start with the right leg, not with the left. Alright? But I'm so for my style, I always use my left. So you just turn me off, like always do the right foot. Even I know we can say that's the lady step. I just do the step because it becomes natural for me because I always dance with my left leg. Yeah? But for my Salsa Nox members, if you are a follower, right, or you wanna do the lady steps, do exactly what I'm doing. Because this is in guaracha, the way it's danced in my country. That's how ladies do it. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. So just follow me, all right? For the ladies, all right? So it's just steps. But for the leads or for the guys, be aware this is the lady step, the way the ladies do it. So make sure when you do it, if you wanna learn from this tutorial, do it the opposite, all right? So if I move the left leg, you guys move the right leg. If I tap with the right leg, guys, you're gonna tap with the left leg. Right? So just I want you to be aware of that. So we do with a basic step of cumbia. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna tap with the right leg in 4. The next thing I'm gonna do is kick. Alright? But now these kicks are pointing down. It's not soccer kicks. You kick here. And we're gonna do a quick switch on my way. So I'm gonna go kick and switch. Alright? I'm gonna play a lot with the corners of the room. Yeah, sorry, we have a visitor here. Chich, say hi. Hi. Now, go away. All right. Dog wants to be in the scene here. All right. Bye-bye. All right, so make sure do a lot of taps and kicks here, all right? So let's say we go here. 1, 2, 3. I want to tap in 4, all right? So my weight's still here. I'll be 5 and 6. So I'm going to switch my weight to my left leg, all right? One more time. So let's do the basic step. So we'll go basic. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Alright? From here, I'm gonna kick with my right leg. Kick here, alright? And then I'm gonna come back here where I start. Alright? And then for now, we're back to the basic step. 1, 2, and 3. Alright? So that's gonna be 8 counts in the music, alright? So, sorry. Basic. One, two, three, and five, six, seven, and we go. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, and five, six, seven. One more time. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, five, six, seven. If I go too fast, please let me know. I know many of you guys probably you never danced guaracha before, or probably you guys not even here, or don't even have an idea what guaracha is. So, just in case, I'm gonna go a little slower, but let me show you how it looks like, right? So, you go with the basic, five, six, seven. One, two, three. Then when I go, I start with the right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, three, five, six, one. So I always do my basic step with a one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight. One, three, and five, six. Seven. You see this? It's a lot of kicks and taps, all right? So slower, you do half of the basic. One, two, and three. Tap and four. Five and six, seven and eight. Then back to the basic here. One, two. Because I'm using the right leg to do the A, so I don't gonna have time to tap. So you go straight back with the basic step. Again, so we go. One, two, three, four, five and six, seven, eight, and one. Two, three, four, five and six, seven, eight, and one. Two, three, four. Five and six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five and six, seven and eight and one. All right? So I want you just to see the three different ways to do this. All right? So you have old school cumbia, put in the middle guaracha, all right? And now cumbia huepa. So it's three different generations, you can say it one way. All right? Even it's three generations, but even these three generations are kind of overlap because the first two is kind of being done at the same time, right? Some people do cumbia only, some people do guaracha and cumbia, so they do, a lot of people that dance guaracha dance just music, right? Because we have a guaracha music, right? But, and we have cumbia music, but it's people that they use guaracha steps and cumbia music, right? Or vice versa, right? People who dance cumbia use it and guaracha music as well, right? And but the one is completely different. Now as times pass, it's a peculiar beat the cumbia huepa has, right? So that's why you can recognize the new kind of style of music that now people are dancing to, because some of the steps, the way they do it a specific way to hit some of the beats in the music, right? So, you can hear it really easy, the difference between the three of them, right? So if you wanna kinda have an idea of the three steps, old school cumbia, you do this. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three. Five, six, seven. One, two, three. Five, six, seven. Sometimes it's different variations of the same step. Another step of cumbia, old school, is this. One, two, three. Five, six, seven, eight. 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 One. All right? Now, guaracha is a little bit different, so it's a lot of more kicks and taps. Now, you're doing guaracha, it will look like this. One, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, seven, eight, and one. All right, so that's kind of like three generations for call it one way, the way we're doing it. All right? Let me see, I think it's a little dark here. Let's see this go. All right, so Now, facing this way, old school cumbia, 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. With the cross, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3. Guaracha, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 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 1. E when cumbia huepa es a little more jumping. 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 7, 8. So it's different. Yeah, I'm sure you guys can see the difference with the steps. Definitely, the more challenging is huepa. It's a lot of work, but I love it. I don't know why. All right. So to continue it with the with a little bit of the guaracha, just to do a little small combination so you guys can do it with the music. So from here, from the first part, we did this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. Just to do a little more, what I'm gonna do is kick with the left leg, then I wanna twist, twist, and twist, right? This coming from rock and roll, or the twist, how we used to do it, all right? So we can incorporate a little bit, a lot of stuff, times in the guaracha, they try to throw some kind of twist or rock and roll steps, old school too, all right? So you do this, right? You go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, and then we can do even more, but I'm gonna keep on to that, all right? So slowly, we do the first part, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. I'm gonna kick to the right, to the corner with my left foot, 1. Now once again, when you do this kick, pointing down, so it make it look nicer. Here, if when I pull the leg, right away I'm gonna twist, moving kind of my knee in front of the other one. So I'm gonna twist, twist, and twist. So I'm gonna twist 3 times. Let me do this way so you can see. First part, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right? Notice that after I go with this kick, I put the leg, I go straight to twist to the left, twist to the right, and twist to the left. All right? So one more time, slow, back with your basic first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, and 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right? So we're in them 4, but we're gonna do something else to complete the 8 counts later. All right? So we don't finish yet. One more time, back to your basic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, facing this way, base is the first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, one more time, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, let's do a couple times a little faster, 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, three, four. Alright? How you guys like it? Let's go to the next part. You have any question, guys, just shoot, let me know. You're going too fast. Yes, I can do slow one more time. No problem. So let me do slower. Now, something you guys can do is like cut it in sections, because then you put like, you try to do the whole thing can be too much, especially the first time trying, right? And then you do this, right? You do four counts at a time, that way you can create the muscle memory that you need. So you go back, one, two, three, four, right? So always start the same way, right? So again, you go one, two, three, four, right? Then you try again. One, two, three, four. Then you try again. One, two, three, four. Once you got the four counts, then you go to the next part, right? So you're doing this, five and six, right? And then you go again, five and six. And then you do again, four, five and six. Do it again, four, five and six, right? Then when you get that part, then you try to put it together and then you repeat it, right? And then you repeat it. All right, Tamara, I think Tamara, you already got it. Let me go to quick because somebody needs a little extra help with this, and then we go to the next part, right? So finish today. Right? So then you put like, there are six counts there. So practice that part, right? So you go back. One, two, three, four, five, and six, all right? And that's it. Then you try again. One, two, three, four. Five and six, right? Notice that here, I finish with my weight in my left. Then you do it again. One, two, three, four, five and six. Then from here, you go to the next part, right? So you says seven and eight, right? It does just eight counts, right? So then you try, then you go back. One, two, three, four, five and six, seven and eight. And you finish there, then you start again. One, two, three, four, five and six, seven and eight. Again, one, two, three, four, five and six, seven and eight. Again, one, two, three, four, five and six and seven and eight. All right? So I hope that's working. So just keep going like that, right? And then you can go to the next part. So use that part is eight counts. That's it. It's just eight counts, right? So you start with the basic. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, and eight. This is eight counts, so work in that part and eight counts, you do it over and over again, guys, right? So once you got those eight counts, then you go to the next part. The eight counts is kicking in that way with the left leg. Okay. Kick, twist, twist, twist. Huh? You're kicking once and you twist three times. You kick with the left, left, then you twist to the left, right, left. In order that all I'm doing is this. Yeah? Kind of like putting one knee in from here, but don't turn, you twist the hips, right? Three times. So that's the next part, the next counts. Kick, twist, twist, and you finish like this. When you weigh your left, right? Then you kick it, kick, twist, twist, twist. This is one, two, three, four. That's four counts. So right now we have eight counts and four counts. So then we do it again, back to the basic. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, all right? And we do it again, we go. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. Last time, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four. All right? It does eight counts plus four counts. All right? So how everybody's getting it? All right? Now, to complete the eight counts, after you finish like this, all right, all I'm gonna do is extend my leg, but don't transfer your weight. Right? So you go tap, all right? And then I'm gonna pull it to cross. step and cross, right? So my weight is gonna end in the front, not in the back, all right? So again, you are in four here, this is gonna be five, right? And six, all right? So you're gonna pull this leg and cross with the left, and six, right? Now your weight is here, notice that this knee is behind the other knee, kind of next to each other, right? Right? It's next to each other, but it's behind. So you can see to the side. Right? So it's not next to each other. It's a little bit in the back. Right? Now, what I'm looking for here is to do a twist with the left foot. And the right one, don't put weight. Right? You just use it to do this. Right? But I don't move in this leg by itself. It's like, imagine this attached to the other leg, but the other one is twisting. So I'm twisting my hips to move this leg in the back. All right, but the twist is happening in the leg in the front. Right? So it's gonna be seven and eight. By eight, I want you to transfer your weight here so you can go with the next step with the left leg. All right? So the last part of our counts after this, and then we twist, twist, and twist, is extend this leg. Extend it to the right. Pull in, cross, then you go quick, quick here. And that will complete the two counts of eight, all right? So, this is gonna be eight. We go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, all right? Now my waist on my right, now I can do the next part with the left leg. And that complete two counts of eight, all right? I hope you guys get in this. If not, let me know, alright? So, let's do it one more time, the last part from the kick. So I'm gonna kick to the right, kick with the left foot, twist, twist, twist. Now I extend this leg, extend it, and I cross. Then I go here and here, and now my waist is my right here, not here. Right. So I can go back with the left if we start again from the basic step. So last time, you're gonna kick five, right, six, seven, and cross here, boom, boom, right, and back with the left leg if we start from the beginning. All right. So let's put everything together, back to your basic step with the left foot. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Seven and eight. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven and eight, and one, two, three, four, five, and six, seven and eight. One, two, three, four, five, and six, seven and eight, and one, two, three, four, five, and six, seven and eight, and one, two, three, four. 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3. Yes, so how you guys got it? If not, you don't get this, and try the steps. But if you are having fun just watching me dance, so that's cool too, I don't mind. So, practiquen, chicos. Díganme si están atorados en alguna parte para poder ayudarles. Si no, tratamos con música. A ver, ¿qué podemos tocar por aquí? Algo lento. Eso era lento, pero ahora lo vamos a hacer regular speed. So if you don't get this, be careful. Let us know. We offer a membership for people that wanna, you know, see our recordings of live that we do. Alright, so just let us know if we can tell you how you guys can join to the membership. Alright, but now I'm gonna try regular speed and be careful, don't fall, keep it safe. It's the same song but regular speed. So la misma canción pero música a la velocidad normal. So cuidado, no se caigan. That was a little bit of guaracha, the way it's called. A lot of the more people do this kind of style, especially in Mexico City. Guaracha over there is strong, right? And you wanna see another type of styles of guaracha, you can go to YouTube. There's plenty of videos over there. Alright, so this is Solano style. This is how I do it. Alright, so I hope you guys like the style. You know, you see, it's many ways to do cumbia. Today was kind of like going through the different phases that cumbia been having. Some of them, right? So I'll show you old school cumbia, guaracha is kind of like later on. Then we have cumbia huepa that was done today. So you see a little bit of the tree. So now you kind of know a little bit of the history. Of course, even in my own country, Mexico, you will see the cumbia around the country is completely different, right? So people, like we have cumbia tejana, right? This in the north of Mexico is completely different. The cumbia has been done in Mexico City, so it's completely two different things, even we are in the same country. All right, so thank you so much guys for come to the live. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit sick. I've been having a cough for over a week. It's not coronavirus, it's just a cough, but
See you guys. Thanks for being the like, and we'll see you next time. I hope you guys like the like. If please, if you have any questions, you're welcome, Irina. Thank you, Samara, Irina, for showing the like. So if you have any questions, please let us know in the Facebook group. And we'll see you next time.